Good morning children. Quadratic equation, word problems we are continuing. A speed of a boat in still water is 11 km per hour. It can go 12 km upstream and return downstream to the original point in 2 hours and 45 minutes. Find the speed of the stream. Such questions, if you remember, we have done in chapter 3 in such a way that certain steps we have to remember. What are that? Let speed of the boat in still water x kilometer per hour and speed of the stream y kilometer per hour and speed of upstream x minus y kilometer per hour, speed of downstream I already told that how to remember means while moving a cycle, you know that speed of the downstream, if you are going downward direction, the speed will be easy, more will be there. That is why adding the speeds. Upstream it is difficult, so kx minus y. Now what is the question? It is given speed of the boat in the still water is 11 km. That means x equal to 11 km per hour. So if that is the situation, then what is the upstream 11 minus y and 11 plus y for downstream. So based on this four steps, if you write correctly, then substitute, then it will be easy for us, right? Now we will write the steps only. 12 km upstream and return downstream, that means distance is same. 12 km upstream it is going and return the same distance only, but the time is taken is 2 hours 45 minutes only. So we will write here downstream and upstream cases. Downstream already speed it is 11 plus y, upstream speed it is 11 minus y, right? Next, distance both the same, it is 12 km, it is also 12 km. Then the total time equal to 2 hours 45 minutes. That means 2 and 45 by 60, 2 and 3 by 4, it is equal to 11 by 4 hours, right? This many things we have calculated. So according to the question, time equal to, we know that distance by speed only, and this is a total time only. Therefore, what we can write, a distance 12 divided by 11 plus y. Similarly, upstream 12, here I have not written the 12 km, 12 divided by 11 minus y, and the total time equal to 11 by 4. So our equation is 12 by 11 plus y plus 12 by 11 minus y equal to 11 by 4 only. Now 12 is a common I'll take. So 1 by 11 plus y plus 1 by 11 minus y equal to 11 by 4. 11 minus y plus 11 plus y divided by 11 minus y into 11 plus y. Here 12 is the and 11 by 4. Now minus y plus y will get cancelled, right? Cross multiplication, 12 into 22 into 4 equal to 11 into 11 square minus y square. So we are cancelling with 11, it will be 2 here. So 12 into 8, that is 96. So here onwards implies we can put 96 equal to 121 minus y square. So y square equal to 121 minus 96. So it is equal to 5. So y equal to plus or minus 5. That means y equal to 5 or y equal to minus 5. This is speed only, so it cannot be negative, so we can cancel. So speed of the stream is the question. So speed of the stream equal to 5 kilometer per hour. A two-digit number is such that the product of its digit is 18. When 63 is subtracted from the number, the digits interchange their places. Find the number. Here also we have to write some introductory steps here. What is that? Let the two-digit number be 2xy, where x is in tens place and y is in unit place. Therefore, the number is 10x plus y. After interchanging the places, interchanging digits, the number is 10y plus x, right? According to the question, product of its digit is 18. Digits only we have to consider here. That means x into y equal to 18. So this is the first equation. Either for x or y for we can write. So y equal to 18 by x. It's a product. X into y we can make it. Equation number 1. Now what is the second part? If 63 is subtracted from the number. So subtracted from the number. Number is which one? 10x plus y. 63 is subtracted. Then its digits are interchanged. So 10y plus x. So 10x plus y minus 10y minus x equal to 63. 10x minus x, that is 9x, minus 9y equal to 63. We can cancel with 9 or we can take common. X minus y equal to 63. Then x minus y equal to 63 by 9, it is equal to 7. Now what is y? 18 by x only. So we are substituting 18 by x there. So using 1, we have x minus 18 by x equal to 7. Taking the LCM, x square minus 18 by x equal to 7, cross multiply, x square minus 18 equal to 7x, or what we can write, x square minus 7x minus 18 equal to 0. Again, factorization method is the same, easy one here also. So 9 and 2 minus 9 plus 2. So x square minus 9x minus plus 2x minus 18 x into x minus 9 plus 2 into x minus 9 equal to 0. So x minus 9 into x plus 2 equal to 0. What is the meaning of this x equal to 9 or x equal to minus 2? So minus 2 is not applicable for us. So what is the number is remaining there? We have taken the number is 10x plus y. That means 10 into 9 plus 2, 92 is the number. So from 92 we can subtract 63, right? Then only the another number will get. So 92 minus 63. We are getting 29. The number is interchanged. This is another point of checking only. Usually your steps will be correct only. If you want, you can check like this also. 1/4 of a herd of camels were seen in the forest. Twice the square root of the herd had gone to mountains and the remaining 15 were seen on the bank of the river. Find the total number of camels. So total number of the camels is the question. So we have to assuming that total number of the camels equal to x. Total number of camels equal to x. Now different situations are given, which are the number of camels seen. First one, in the forest. Next, mountain. Next, bank of the river. So three situation is given. Now we have to identify how they are. So I'll read the sentence once again. 1/4 of herd of camels were seen in the forest. 1/4 of total camels, that is x by 4. Twice the square root of the herd, that means 2 into twice the square root of the herd, that is gone to mountains, remaining 15. So according to the question, what we can write, x by 4 plus 2 root x plus 15 equal to x, that is total number of camels. Now take the LCM, x plus 2 root x plus 15 by 4 means here I should multiply with 4 into 4 whole divided by 4 equal to x, implies x plus 8 root x plus 60 equal to 4x. I am taking all the terms to other side. So 0 equal to 4x minus x minus 8 root x minus 60 implies 3x minus 8 root x minus 60 equal to 0 only. Now here we have learned x square method only for quadratic, right? So here root forms are coming. So what we should do means we are replacing root x as y only. So here what we are taking, put root x equal to y. So what is root x square? Then root x square equal to y square implies x equal to y square, right? So the equation 1 becomes 3y square minus 8y minus 60 equal to 0. 8 root x became 8y because root x we have taken as a y, right? Now what is our y square? It is x only. So x is replaced with the y square. So x variable we have changed into y by taking root x equal to y only. Now what is the next step? 3y square minus 8y minus 60 equal to 0. That is our equation, which is a quadratic form we are having. Now 180 is the number. That is minus 16 to 30, minus 180 is the number where the factors are required. So what are the factors required here? That is 60 and 3 we can use, but it's a correct, I think 10 and 18 only. So minus 18 and 10. Okay, you will get a minus 18 because of the middle term sign is minus and the 10 is positive. Again, splitting the middle term, 3y square minus 18y plus 10y minus 60 equal to 0. 3y common, y minus 6 plus 10 common, y minus 6 in bracket again. So what is the next step? 3y plus 10 into y minus 6 equal to 0. So y equal to minus 10 by 3 or y equal to 6. Anyhow, it is a number of camels only, so it cannot be fraction. So which is the possible value? Y equal to 6. Y equal to 6 only possible. Now what is the case now? If y equal to 6, right, what this implies? Root x equal to 6. Root x equal to 6. Then what is x? Therefore, root x square equal to 36. That means x equal to 36. Therefore, number of camels equal to 36. Only the change of quadratic equation you have to remember in this question. It's one of the important question only. Out of a group of swans, 7 by 2 times the square root of the total number of swans are playing on the shore of a pond. The two remaining ones are swimming in the water. Find the total number of swans. So here also it is similar to the previous question only. So solution, let the total number of swans equal to x only. Now number of swans playing on the pond, on the shore of the pond, 7 by 2 times the square root of swans. Now the remaining one equal to 2. So according to the question, what we can write, total number of swans means the first swan is on the shore only, 7 by 2 root x plus 2, that is equal to x, right? Now take the LCM only, 7 root x plus 4 equal to 2x. We are bringing all the terms to one side, so 2x minus 7 root x minus 4 equal to 0. So we got here also root x only. So what is the next step? Put y equal to root x implies y square equal to root x square. That means y square equal to x. So I'll make it equation 1 here. Therefore, equation 1 becomes 2y square minus 7y minus 4 equal to 0. 2 into minus 4, it is minus 8 only. So our factors are minus 8 and plus 1. Again, factor method, almost all the questions we have used the factor method only. So 2y square minus 8y plus y minus 4 equal to 0 only. So what is common here? 2y into y minus 4 plus 1 into y minus 4 equal to 0. Again, which is common? Y minus 4 is common. Again, 2y plus 1 equal to 0 only. So this means y equal to 4 or y equal to minus 1 by 2. Why it is not possible? Because it's a number of swans only. So y equal to 4. That means if y equal to 4, then y square equal to x equal to 4 square only. it is equal to 16. Therefore, number of swans equal to 60. So here also we have changed the same way, the way last sum we have done. Here also we got root x only, so we changed into y by taking y equal to root x. Change that steps clearly, remember that step, practice that step. With this, today's class I am winding up. Thank you.